You may ask, how can I list content items? Because we have seen that you can specify the permalink or author out part will automatically generate the permalink for you for a given content item, and then you can use that URL to access that content item. All right, but what if I have multiple content items? How can I list them? And there is one thing that we have previously seen under Lucene and indexing and search, and that was that under search and queries we have this recent blog posts query, and this is actually the query that produces the blog post list on the front end. But actually there is nothing here. But let's go back to our blog, and yeah, it's now in a draft, possibly because of importing. Yeah, and now we have the blog posts here. So that's one way to do it, but let's actually take another look. Because if you open blog, we also have a list of blog posts here, and that's not the same list than the recent blog posts. And the reason for it is that under blog, we actually have a blog content item. Actually, it's not really visible here, but if we go to the content item list, we can open the blog content item. And the blog content item is a container for blog posts. So you might not notice, but there is actually another content item, not just the blog post, but there is also the blog. You see? And if we edit this blog content item, we also see that it also has a title, it also has a permalink, hence why we can retrieve it under blog, under slash blog, and image, and blah, blah, blah. So how does this work? Why can a content item include other content items or be a parent of other content items? And that's one way to list content items and define a hierarchy in Orchard. And how it is done is that under a content type blog, the list part is also added. And the list part is, well, as it also says here, it adds listing behavior to content items. You will be able to kind of attach other content items to content items. And if we edit the settings of list part, we also see what we can do here. Yeah, we can configure the page size here. We can also configure which content items to include in that list, and a few other things that are less important. So in the end, blog is pretty much a list of blog posts. So great. And really, it's pretty much about that. The list part is for creating a hierarchical relationship between content items, where one content item will contain the other content items. There is no ordering by default or no other metadata, and nothing else. And also the contained content items are their own very separate content items, reachable under their own permalink. Now, contrasted to that, there is also flow parts, which we have already seen. If we take a look at our first demo page, we have seen how to create these widgets on the front end with flow part, how we put these widgets into flow part. And as I said there, all of these widgets are their own content items actually. Now, the big difference is that in this case, the page fully contains those content items. You can't access these content items separately via permalink. Well, actually you could, there is a URL where you can access them, but the concept is that these are not really independently living content items. These content items are always within the page. And with flow parts, you get all kinds of styling and structuring functionality for them. There is another very similar part actually, which is called back part. So if we just open any content type here and add a part, you see that there is also back part. Now, back part is really similar to flow part. The big conceptual difference is that it doesn't offer any structuring, layout specific features, any styling. That's pretty much it. So until now, we have seen pretty much three ways to list and contain content items. Well, list part, flow part, back part, and we had one option to also query content items with Lucene queries. Let's check that out in a bit more detail again, and let's also write an SQL query. Well, again, where we are now is under search queries. So as we discussed before, this query that we have here is a Lucene query, so a query against a Lucene index, which you can also think of as a NoSQL database, because it really is. And this index is then displayed from the theme on the homepage of the site. So if we go here, and there is another way to query content items too, and that is SQL queries. And there is an important concept to note here. You see the storage of content items and the querying of content items is disconnected. It doesn't have to use the same technology, because currently we are storing content items in an SQL database. But in this example, we are querying those content items via Lucene queries. And similarly, we could store content items somewhere else, even in a Lucene index or in flat files, and we could query them via Lucene queries, or we could query them via SQL queries. Now, if you are storing content items in an SQL database, then querying them via SQL too is quite natural, but as I said, it's not necessary, and these two things, querying and storage, are not necessarily the same. They don't have to be the same. In this case with Lucene queries, they aren't, but let's also try out SQL queries. Now, SQL queries are in their own feature, or it is its own feature called SQL queries. And now, now under queries, we can also run an SQL query, or we can also add an SQL query here. We won't go into too much details here, but if you are interested, there's ample documentation on the documentation site here about how these queries work. But basically, what happens here is that there is a very specific SQL interpreter behind the scenes. So don't worry if you write drop table, it won't work, because this is really an SQL interpreter just for the queries feature. It just knows select, it just knows specific clauses. Their SQL injection is not really possible with this. There are other kinds of attacks possible, but not SQL injection. And what we can do now is that we can create a very similar query, like the Lucene query for recent blog posts, but this time with SQL. So let's actually create that. Yeah, and the name can be recent blog posts SQL or something. The schema, schema can, here you can specify the JSON schema when the results are returned as JSON. That's not really necessary in this case. You can also specify to actually return the, well, now we are again using the term documents. So we'll look into how the database of Orchard looks like. but it's a document database or a document database concept, document database approach within an SQL database. And this is what we are referring to. When you want to display the documents, so in this case, the content items that this query returns, you want this checked. And the query, I happen to have a query on my clipboard that will fetch all the published blog posts. You can see a bit more examples under the documentation, but this query is fairly simple. We are actually querying the content item index, which is an index table for content item documents. But don't worry, we'll take a look at index records and how all of that works when we start to create our own module. But for now, let's save this query. And we can actually run it to see whether it works. Well, it doesn't. This should actually be like this. Apparently copy-paste error. So let me go back and edit the query. And now let's run it again. This time it's good. It returns a single document. Well, there is just one blog post in the system, so that's what we await. And now let's also create something to display this. Remember that we have talked about Liquid multiple times before. We can also create a Liquid page from the admin here. So basically a page where we define a dynamic layout or a programmatic layout with the Liquid markup syntax. So let's create a Liquid page here. Let's call it recent blog post or something like that. And in the body here, we need to use Liquid. So what I will do now is that I will use this piece of Liquid, which again happens to be on my clipboard. Magically, I don't know how it works. I don't make the rules. And what this Liquid does is that it retrieves our query. And well, it uses this Liquid filter called query. This is Orchard feature. And again, this is documented, so you don't have to know this from the top of your head. We fetch the query, we assign those content items to these recent blog post variable. We pretty much for each through those variables, and we display the display text of those content items. So again, the display text is just a generalization of title. It can come from title part, but it doesn't necessarily have to come from title part. For blog posts, it's the same as title. So let's publish it. And let's see what happens when we open it on the admin. Although we could have used the preview. And you can see that, well, again, it's just a single item list, but we have the results here, the display text of our blog posts. So, fairly simple until now about both Lucene and SQL queries and Liquid are very powerful concepts and very powerful features. So I encourage you to check out the documentation for more details.